Hey everyone, and welcome to another episode of Hashtag Vlogger. So for today's video, I will be sharing with you guys itong isa sa mga pinaka in-demand ngayon na digital banking. Ito yung CIMB Bank PH. So this bank is very much known in Malaysia, and now they were launched here in the Philippines para mag-offer ng high interest savings account. And ito yung bank na trinay ko when I came back here in the Philippines. And for today, I'll be sharing with you guys my experience, the advantages, the perks, and the disadvantages of having CIMB savings account. And of course, kung paano ba mag-open ng savings account sa kanila. So, if you guys are interested and if you guys want to know more about CIMB Bank PH, please keep on watching! So, let's start right away with what is CIMB. It's one of the most known digital banks here in the Philippines. And ang mga perks that you will enjoy is that less hassle. You don't need to go to any physical bank because processing is all online. Even the fund transfer and pagde-deposit is all online. And even yung pag-a-apply, online na lang din. But sa mga perks that you will enjoy if you have a CIMB account is that it has a high interest rate na mas malaki compared sa mga local banks natin kung saan natin nilalagay yung mga savings natin. Based on my research, CIMB Bank is also one of the most awarded digital banks here in the Philippines. If I'm not mistaken, they currently have 8 awards. So, marami kasi ngayon ang nagbo-boom na digital banks such as yung Ing, which I think is from Singapore naman. Meron din yung Como from eSwiss. Meron ding itong CIMB, and meron pang isa pero nakalimutan ko yung tawag. But ito yung mga most known ngayon and prominent ngayon sa social media. And if you're gonna search right away for a savings account with high interest rates, definitely sila yung lalabas. Just a disclaimer, this video is not affiliated with CIMB. I am not affiliated with CIMB. I'm just sharing with you guys my experience with it. And para lang din sa information nyo if this bank is legit or not, and of course the advantages that we could enjoy if we have a CIMB account. But I'm also not encouraging you to have one if hindi nyo feel and if you're not really informed about it and if you didn't do your thorough research about it. First question, is CIMB Bank legit? Based on my experience and research, CIMB Bank is also a member of the PDIC or Philippine Deposit Insurance Corporation, kung saan yung mga local banks natin such as BPI, BDO, Union Bank ay member din. This only means that yung mga pera natin na nilalagay natin sa savings account na yon ay protected and secured by PDIC and insured siya. So kung maglalagay man tayo ng pera, definitely it's safe to put or place our money there. So, magkonting history lang tayo. They founded CIMB in the year 1974, and by 2018, if I'm not mistaken, it was launched here in the Philippines. And hindi ko sure kung by 2018 medyo popular na tong CIMB, but only nung December 2020 ko siya nalaman kasi nag-research lang ako about sa mga savings account with high interest rates, and nalaman ko lang siya December 2020 nung umuwi ako galing Japan. Next question, how to start an account in CIMB? Since digital bank nga siya, downloadable ito sa Play Store and App Store. So madali lang yan, i-search nyo lang yung CIMB Bank PH and lalabas na siya agad. Sa digital bank, all the transactions are done online, even yung application. Well, the good thing about this is that they also offer a debit card, but it depends on the type of the account that you're gonna get. So, meron silang 3 different types of account, which I'm gonna discuss later sa mga susunod pang parts ng video na to. Now, we move on to the 3 types of the account. So, what are the 3 types of account na in-offer ni CIMB? So, they've got fast account, they've got upsave, and yung GSave. So, what I have personally is yung GSave, but For the two accounts, pwede ko rin naman silang i-apply pero hindi pa ako nag-a-apply as of the moment. Ang alam ko, nagkakaiba-iba sila sa interest rate. So, if nagtataka kayo, wala ba silang physical office? They have a physical office located in Taguig and here's the complete address. Okay, so let's start with the Fast account and Fast Plus account. So these are not really different from each other. It's just that kapag Fast account, meron kang parang expiration. So basta until 12 months ka lang pwedeng mag-save and after that you need to get your money afterwards. Or basta you have to accumulate 100,000 pesos within 12 months. And then after that, ma-upgrade ka na into Fast Plus account. Interest rate niya is 0.75% per ano. Dito, pwede ka mag-acquire ng debit card for free as long as you have 5,000 pesos in your account. Ayun. So after noon, pwede ka na mag-apply. Request it to be delivered sa bahay niyo mismo. So, maraming nagtatanong, what are the benefits ba of having a debit card? Using that debit card, you can withdraw from over 20,000 BankNet ATMs. BankNet nga ba? BankNet, yeah, correct. BankNet ATMs here in the Philippines. So, para ka lang ding merong ATM from your local bank and pwede ka lang din mag-withdraw anytime you want as long as you have, of course, the money in your account. Basta, meron ka 100,000 pesos. That's actually a big amount for me. So, hindi ako nagkuha ng Fast account. But then again, if you want something na parang, oh, may debit card, can get your money right away, and you have enough money naman to put in that account, then why not get a Fast account or Fast Plus account? Ang kagandahan dito is that in 10 minutes, makakagawa ka na agad ng account mo. And as I've said, online nga lang yung application, online din yung approval nila. And once you're approved, they're just gonna send you a message through text or through email na approve na and you can start navigating the app and you can start depositing your money sa bank or sa savings account mo. Bakit ba ako nag-open ng digital bank din? Kasi the good thing about this is that pag magpa-fund transfer ka, you don't need to pay for like the fee. It's all free. Also, ang maganda rito is that it has no initial deposit and no minimum balance. Pwede ding maka-withdraw anytime, anywhere without penalty charges. So, same lang yung eligibility for all the three accounts that I will mention and later on, i-flash ko siya sa screen. Next one is the UpSave account. Medyo hindi ako familiar dito kasi hindi ko siya masyadong na-research. But ito lang yung alam ko sa UpSave account. Una, mas mataas yung interest rate niya compared sa Fast and Fast Plus account. It has 3% per annum. Ang alam ko dati, it's 4% per annum. Pero ngayon, change nila because also, dahil sa pandemic, they had to really adjust as well. Ngayon, 3% na lang per ano. Also, it doesn't have an initial deposit and no minimum balance required. But, ang downfall lang dito is that it has no debit card. So, lahat ng transactions mo online lang. Ang proof mo is online lang din. So, dahil nga wala ko masyadong alam sa UpSave account, give me information about it. Comment down below if meron ba akong misinformation. If you have further details for UpSave account. But the next thing is GSave account. Kung meron kayong GCash, mapapansin nyo doon, merong save money icon. So, yung GSave money is connected to the CIMB Bank. So, nakuha nila si Globe, si CIMB, and they are partnered to give you a high interest savings account. Ang alam ko, 3.1% per annum to. And last year, if I'm not mistaken, 4.1 din sila. Pero yun nga, nag-change because of the pandemic. So ngayon, 3.1 per annum sila. But same thing with UpSave. And Fast account, no initial deposit, and no minimum balance required. So, kung meron kang GCash, you can easily open an account straight from your GCash app. So, yun, pindutin mo lang doon yung GSave or Save Money icon, and then you can link everything sa GCash mo, and you can just withdraw and deposit money using your GCash app as well. Yun nga, as I've mentioned, since linked sila, since partner sila, you can access your account sa GCash mo, which is a good thing kasi sobrang convenient lang ngayon yung GCash. And also, you can access it sa CIMB app mismo, but merong process sa pag-link nung account mo na yon. And if you guys want to know, I'll make a video about it. Pero yun nga, madali lang naman siya. Ililink mo lang yung account mo na yon para meron ka both sa GCash and sa CIMB Bank. And all of these three accounts that I've mentioned, wala ring annual fees, and yun nga, walang initial deposit, walang average daily balance. I found out that they also offer a life insurance, but that is if you have like a daily balance per month of like 100,000 pesos. That's quite big, but if you have like a lot of savings with you, then probably hindi naman siya ganun kasakit sa bulsa. If you have it, then libre mo lang makukuha yung life insurance that they offer. Also, the app is very easy to use. Para lang siyang GCash, ganun lang siya kadali gamitin. You can just easily transfer money, withdraw money. Yeah, you can use it to pay your bills. Tulad ng mga na-enjoy natin sa GCash natin, sa Paymaya, sa mga local banks natin. Same lang din siya sa SIM. And also, isa pa sa mga pinaka gusto ko sa CIMB is that their customer service is really fast. And tatawag ka lang kahit through your phone or through landline. And you can talk to their live agent for free. Wala naman siyang bayad kahit sa phone. I've tried. Pero sa telephone, hindi ko pa na-try sa landline nila tumawag. But sa phone, yeah, for free, you can talk to their live agents. As long as, syempre, yung oras, siguro 9 to 6, yon. Hindi ko lang sure sa gabi kasi during that time, tumawag ako ng morning. And mabilis naman yung transaction. I just asked how to link my GSave and my CIMB bank. Para pag nag-login ako, isa lang. Ayun. Also, I'm not sure if this is true, but you can also use your card for travel. Also, for personal loan. So, if you want to apply for loan, pwede din. Now, let's move on to the disadvantages. Syempre, hindi lamang pwedeng puro advantages, puro perks, but also merong risks as well and disadvantages. As I've mentioned, it's a digital bank. And also, syempre, yung mga scammers natin, digital na din. So, parang mas magiging madali siya para ma-scam ka or magamit yung account mo. So, I really, really recommend na to take care of your passport, to of course know your account and i-keep mo siya and make sure na yung mag-a-access nung phone mo is syempre kakilala mo lang din kasi nga connected siya sa phone, connected din siya sa email, connected siya sa PC and all. So yun, marami rin kasi mga scammer ngayon. Dapat ingatan lang din natin yung mga personal information natin by ourselves or sa family members, yung mga talagang tinatrust lang din natin. Isa pa sa disadvantage nila is yung money transfer timeline nila is medyo matagal. So, for example, gusto mo mag-transfer and nasend mo yung request like 1 p.m. So, kapag 1 p.m. onwards, next banking day na siya pwede. Next banking day na siya magre-reflect. Also, kapag weekends, of course, every Monday mo na makukuha or every Monday na siya magre-reflect. So, yun lang. Yun yung, I think, mga cons sa mga digital banks. So, ayun lang naman. Overall, my experience with SIMB or CIMB is great. So far, wala pa akong na-encounter na problems with them as of the moment. And I can say that my money is secure with CIMB. Again, this video is not sponsored by CIMB. I'm just sharing with you guys my experience kasi I wanted to have like a savings account with high interest rate. And of course, syempre, gusto ko yung legit na bank na matatrust ko din. And yun, I think CIMB is the right choice. So, ayun lang naman. If you guys have any good or bad experience with CIMB, I hope you can share it with me. Message me your comment down below if may gusto kayong information na i-include ko dito sa vlog na to or for my next vlog. Or also, you can share your experiences with me sa comment section or suggest any vlog for me. So, ayun lang for today's video. Thank you guys for watching and I'll see you on my next vlog. Thank you!